cybersecurity professionals, incident response planning is a critical part of the job. So recently, they came together to compare notes, as I learned from ICI's cybersecurity expert, Peter Salmon.
You know, the purpose of having the panel is to show the interconnectedness between different roles within an organization, get the different perspectives, what goes on during an incident, when to involve certain individuals, certain functions, and internal and external. And, you know, the purpose is to reinforce with everybody that you have to have this plan in place and exercised before something goes wrong. Because, you know, during an emergency, it's not the time to try to figure out what steps within your procedures you should be doing, who should be notifying, and who did what, when, and why. So this sort of just highlights all the steps and considerations that firms need to take into account when there is a problem.
So this was really a rare opportunity within the industry for asset managers to take a look at other companies' plans, compare notes, and see how theirs stacks up.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the exchange of ideas is incredibly valuable. People come at this with different years of experience, different backgrounds, and so it's just a healthy exchange of people facing the same challenge, and how do they approach that, and how do they mitigate that.
You had a lot of different perspectives in the room and on that panel.
Absolutely, and communications is a key part of this because, you know, depending on the nature of the incident, there's going to have to be communications either with investors, with the public generally, perhaps with other entities. So you're going to want that planned out, and the communications professional needs to be involved in these discussions.
And the very fact that you had a communications professional on the panel indicates that this was not your typical lineup in a cybersecurity conference. You were really having people think much more broadly about this issue and the people they have involved in their response plan.
Well, for me, it's a reinforcement of what the Institute has been doing for a while, is highlighting the key role that law enforcement plays in incident response plans. And it's not a question of calling them when they don't know who you are, because you'll just get a switchboard number and they won't know how to direct you. You need to have a relationship established before an incident takes place. And we've gone out, you know, not only here in the United States, but abroad, and reemphasized that and actually introduced individual agents to our members so that they can include that specific agent's name and number in their incident response plans.